गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग
सर. गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
या गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन दिस सेशन बेसिकली लेट मी सी हु हैज जॉइंड टुडे. मीन्स दे हैव नॉट जॉइंड यस्टरडे एंड लास्ट क्लास. So can you start the video? I think 2-3 students have registered yesterday. I have their name, maybe name or email ID, and I have joined them in our LMS system. So maybe they got the mail and they accept the mail. Okay. Is anyone new one here? Total we have 49 participants including me, 50 participants including me.
Kam ho gaya hai.
Okay, no problem. 2-3 are not there. It happens. Okay. Fine. So let us begin. So I'm just sharing my screen. If you are able to see my screen, go to chat box and type capital Y. Okay. So basically, in this today's session, we are trying to work on a demo on R. So what it means, so far we have seen one lecture based on basic of R and introduction of R, then what are the advantage, what are the disadvantage, then how it works and what are the features of R. Now today's session, we will actually how it works, that we will see in this session. So our today's agenda, hands-on practice on RStudio. So if you have a laptop and you can say desktop, you can work on directly on app or software. If you don't have, you can go for RStudio Cloud. So that basically we work on RStudio Cloud also. And then very important, our Canvas system, that is a platform where you will be get all materials and you can work on that platform. That our one lecture agenda. And the next lecture, we will introduce some other agenda. So I'll try to finish this in one lecture. So let us begin. So I'm just sharing another screen where you have can you see my screen here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So how it runs? So let me start with very basics. You can start by going RStudio. Just type in your Windows RStudio. When you type RStudio, you can see RStudio is already installed in your PC. Once you click on that, this is your snapshot of your front page. So once you open that software, it will look like this. Can you see there is a four partition here? Everyone can see four partitions?
Yes, sir.
You can put on chat box because everything is vibrating here. So I'll keep everyone mute and then chat box.
Yes, sir.
Is it still not mute? So there is a four partition. Left top you can call source window, editor window. Left bottom you can call console window, where you're going to whatever program you execute in source window, that will reflect on console window. And right top you have an environment. You have an environment and history, connection, everything. And right bottom, you have all files, packages, and plot. So one can start with, by clicking here, this plus sign, you can start with the new, as you can open new file here. Or you can just go to file and click on new file. And click on R script, or one can go directly here just by clicking this plus sign R script. So once you type R script, automatically it will give untitled one, untitled two. It is basically your by default system. So if I click on this R studio, that plus sign, it will give me untitled one. Means you can see, I'm just taking very basic, starting from the basic. Very, very basic. I know the 70% is already knowing these all basics. They initially they will get bored because what sir is teaching, everything, like we are knowing everything. So that's okay. But I'm starting from basic because 30% students are not knowing. So that is the incorporating with the 30% students, you have to start with all this basic. So this is the how you can start your how you can take a new file. So whenever you click on this plus sign, you can get the new tab. This is called new file. Now suppose I have a command here. I'll tell you the this R studio is a case sensitive in the sense, suppose I have a variable x and I'm just giving this sign x. Now this is my x. This variable x is my name of the variable. You write now, let's say height and weight. Height and weight is your variable. And that height and weight are taking some values. So that values is this. Similarly, x is my variable. And that x value is taking one. So this is the x, which is called variable. This sign, what is this sign? This sign is called as assignment sign. We call na, this is equal. So how you write this? Write down less sign and there is a dash button. If you have laptop, you can say there is a dash button. So whenever it's less than dash sign, this is called assignment. So I'm assigning x equal to 1. So x is equal to 1. Now you can see here, when you move your cursor, there is a one option called run. If you see on run, once you just move your cursor on run, you can see it is showing that press control plus enter. So by default, there is an option control plus enter. So if you are using your laptop, if you just press control and enter, it will run. Or you can run directly click by run. So if I'm just clicking by run here, see, I hope you can able to see this console window also, because if I execute x is equal to one, I'm getting here x is equal to one directly. But whatever I'm executing, same thing is displaying here, but I don't actual value of x. So if I'm writing x, or let's say capital X is equal to and I'll press Control and Enter. See what is that? What is the output? Error. Object X is not found. अभी क्या होता है? 50% students are always get this error. So you don't call me always. Okay? You try to rectify your error. How? Now this object is not found. That means that the object which you have entered, which is not matching with your variable. Now this is the capital, this is the small x, and this is the capital X. So it is case sensitive. Why it is called case sensitive? Because if I have entered variable X, which is small, you are supposed to write small only. Otherwise, it will say you will be get the error. Object X is not found. So let's write on small x. If I write small x and press on run, see what is my output. Can you see here what is my output? Console window, X, it is a bracketed one. Bracketed one means we have a first column, and what is my output? Output is 1. That means X is taking 1. X is taking 1. Similarly, if I define, let's say Y, Y is equal to 1. Now see, there is a different way of writing. One can write this less than equal to sign. One can write this equal sign. Both the meaning is same. It is assignment only. But better to use less than equal to sign, because most preferable is this. If I again press Control Enter, it will display Y is equal to 1. But I want to see the value of Y. So whenever you want to see the value of Y, you want to see the value of any variable, you're supposed to write Y and run it. See, you'll get again Y is equal to 1. But let's define Y is equal to another second one. Y is equal to 2. So now see, you have edit this. You have edit this. And you have edit but not run it. So until unless you will not run it, Y ka value jo rahega, wo 1 hi rahega. So you have to run first this and then run this. So automatically it will display 2. So I have stored X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 2. So I have created how many variables? 2 variables. Okay. Now I wanted to know how many variables I have actually. I wanted to know how many variables I have actually. So you can go directly, just type LS. LS means I'm just listing all variables. I'm just listing all variables. Once you run it this, it will display X and Y. See, X and Y. I have a two variable X and Y. And can you see this X and Y? If you see right top window, there is X and Y values. And these values are taking 1 and 2. Can you see in the chat box if you have any difficulties so far? Because this is actually demo. Actual demo. Any difficulties so far? Anyone? So we can proceed. Now, suppose I am interested to go for, I am just creating a new variable, which is Z is equal to X plus Y. So I have defined a new variable Z is equal to X plus Y. So run it and see. See, it is executed, but it is not executing what will be the value of Z. So whenever you want to see the value of Z, type Z and run it. So output will be 3. And can you see here automatically one more variable here created, which is called 3, which is called Z, and that value is taking 3. So again, you want to see the value of LS. So you can see what is list. LS means Can you hear me, everyone? Can you hear me, everyone? Go to chat box, type. I don't know, suddenly, sir, something happened here. Okay, anyways. So we were at a variable. So whenever we are interested to know the variables, you can always go for how many variables are there. Just type ls open bracket, close bracket. Just call list of variables. Voice is coming here, everyone. My voice is coming. It is not coming. Now it is coming. Can you hear me? Just type in chat box. Can you hear me? Everyone can hear me. Why not? I think everything is working properly from my side. Check your mics, check your mic properly. Maybe some connection problem is there. Now it is audible to all. Audible to all. Hello. Can you hear me? Okay. Have you understood the variable, how to create a variable first? Because it is a very, very important part, how to create a variable. So same thing we can run it on R cloud also. So if I execute now, see what I did here. Actually, I have written ls open bracket, close bracket, and I have written, this is the you can say has list of variables. Now if I run this, see what it means. Whenever you want to write a comment, means what is this ls? Ls is my list of variables. So whenever you write the comment by writing has, it doesn't affect in my syntax. Always remember, it doesn't affect my syntax. So whenever you want to write syntax regarding the comment, so always go by writing has list of variables. Why it is lagging there, I don't know. Okay, anyways, so if I run this, I will get the output x, y, z. Why it is lagging? I will share again so that maybe some connection problem is there. Close. Can you hear me now properly, everyone? Can you see my screen? It is Google browser. Go to chat box right now. turn off my video. That's why I think maybe some problem with that connectivity. Okay. So let's see how it works in R cloud. Let's see how it works in R cloud. Hello, can you hear me now properly? No. Why no? Why?
No.
Yeah, can you hear me?
आपका वॉइस ब्रेक हो
रहा है सर. वॉइस ब्रेक हो रहा है आपका.
क्यों इतना ब्रेक हो रहा है?
कनेक्शन प्रॉब्लम है शायद. बीच-बीच में हो रहा है बार-बार.
हां सर, और वीडियो भी अटक रहा है
सर. रीस्टार्ट करो सर.
क्या रीस्टार्ट करो? सेशन?
नो सर, मतलब नेट बंद करके वापस से चालू करो.
आपका
सर एयरप्लेन मोड पे डाल के देखो.
अच्छा ऐसा है क्या? वापस
से एक बार लीव हो के वापस ज्वाइन हो जाओ सर.
ओके ओके.
अरे तो वॉइस कौन रहेगा?
अभी अभी आ रहा है? क्लियर? अभी क्लियर आ रहा है?
नहीं,
आवाज ब्रेक हो रहा है सर.
ब्रेक हो के आ रहा
है. थैंक यू सचिन
सर. ऐसा लग रहा है कि हवा हवा आ रहा है सर.
Let me join that one second.
Vicky Skinner.
Hey.